Are you naturally a starter or are you naturally a finisher? See, most people are only consistently good at either starting or finishing, but not both. So depending which you are determines how you need to plan your day for maximum productivity. So some people are starters. You're good at taking action. You don't overthink things. You just jump right in. But then you might fall prey to boredom or distraction or ADD sets in and you have a hard time finishing things. So you start a bunch of stuff, but you don't always see it through. Then there's finishers on the other hand. Now finishers are more prone to procrastination or overthinking. So we have a harder time getting started, but once you actually get into the zone, then you finish things strong and you get it done. You just knock it out. So here's how to plan your day accordingly, depending which one you most naturally tend to be. So for my starters, you will be better off planning one simple thing to do every single day. So if you have a bigger project that you need to be working on, chunk it down into just one step, because one simple step doesn't cause any resistance for you. If it's just one thing, you'll just knock it out, no problem. It's when you've got a lot of things and you really have to dig in deep, or there's 15 steps that you got to do to a particular thing, that's when you tend to kind of lose your focus and lose momentum. So instead, one thing every single day, short, sweet, but it keeps a cadence and you'll actually get more done over the longer term than you feel like you are by just one simple step at a time. Now my finishers, I'm a finisher, which means that I'm more prone to procrastination or overthinking. So the thing for us is we actually need longer chunks of time to get stuff done. So if your week is peppered with meetings and you wind up with these little chunks of time in between, you got 15 minutes here, 30 minutes there, an hour there, it's not enough time to get stuff done. So you wind up filling the time that you do have with just busy work, just responding to emails and nonsense. So instead, stack all your meetings together so you can free up a larger chunk of time that you can really dig into some project or series of projects that you need to do to be working on your business and not just in your business. When you have your scheduled time, make your list, know exactly what you want to accomplish in advance, because once you get started, there's a good chance you're gonna knock out 10 things at once, or you're gonna finish that one big thing. You're just gonna knock it out and finish it strong. So here's my last tip for both my starters and my finishers. Don't beat yourself up for whatever you're not. The world needs starters and the world needs finishers. The key is just to build up the people and the systems around you to supplement and to carry through where you don't naturally have a strength. So do me a favor and leave me a comment. Let me know, are you naturally a starter or are you naturally a finisher? And if there's a tip that works for you to help you finish or to help you start, let us know what that is as well. Thanks for watching.